bonus video number one, setting background music. If you've completed everything else and your game is working and you showed it to me, I guess you're ready to continue. We're going to add some music, but this is how we're going to do it. What is music? Music is sound, so we're going to go a little bit faster now, so get ready. Right click, create sound, change this to SND_music. And now we're going to load sound. I'm going to select from one of these two music.mid, which stands for MIDI files. I'm going to select the second one and click on open. We're going to click on OK. Now when you double click on it, you should be able to preview it by clicking right over here. It might take a while to load, and then you should be able to hear it. All right. You won't be able to hear mine, but you can hear yours. And now you're going to hit OK when you're done. And we need to make sure that the music loops forever. And we're going to do that by attaching our soundtrack to the ball. Double click on the ball object. I'm going to move over to create. And we're going to navigate to the main one tab. And then play sound, drag it underneath the create. And we're going to select sound music. And this time, we're going to set the loop to true instead of false, which means it's going to loop forever. You can click OK. And then we're going to click OK again. I'm going to Control S. And then we're going to press F5 to test. Do you hear it? You should be able to hear the music, hear when the ball hits the wall, and hear when you click on it. All right, this game's starting to look better and better. Man, I'm still struggling to hit these. Okay, press escape. What we're gonna do next, we're gonna add some backgrounds to our stage. So get ready if you're still ready to go.